Good morning and welcome back to the vlog. Man, today's going to be a pretty good day. See, I'm playing hooky from the regular 9-to-5 job to do something pretty awesome. Something that you don't really get a chance to do very often. I am heading down to Rotterdam this morning with some friends, and we are taking part in, or we've been invited to, the Royal Enfield Meteor launch. So it's a launch event. They're launching the new Meteor today. Well, they launched it yesterday. We're on day two down in Rotterdam for Benelux, which is Belgium, Netherlands, and Luxembourg. So we're heading down there now. It's about 6:30 in the morning. We're meeting at a gas station along the highway. And yeah, big, exciting day. So let's get on the road and get down there.
How's it going? Look at this thing. It's awesome, man. It's super comfortable for this too, isn't it? My man, how's it going?
Okay, so we just finished the presentation part, or the morning presentation part of this launch event. Now, if you're wondering what a launch press event is, it's just that. The brand, or in this case, the distributor, invites a bunch of press to come and try out the new motorcycles, ride them around, and tell you all of the specs of the new motorcycles. It's basically their way of starting the conversation in the country and starting to build momentum for the models when they're going to launch. So now we're doing the first ride section of the day. The first part of the day is going to be a ride through the city. Me and the other guys that I came with, we're not taking part in that. We have to do some photos for some other publications, and we this is our only time to get our hands on the bike. So they're gonna roll out and do a city trip around Rotterdam. We're gonna go and find some spots to go make some photos. So yeah, that's where we're going now. We're gonna jump on the bikes and go hunt down a location. So let's get to riding. Yeah, this is location number one. It's this dock with all these yachts around and everything. So we're moving the bikes all over the waterfront, or not the waterfront, all over the dock to try to get unique perspectives that nobody else is going to have. Because we really want our photos to stand out from everybody else that's here so that we can hopefully get a little bit more traction. But I gotta put this down so that I can keep, I gotta keep shooting. So we found location number two for the morning. It's this industrial area. I don't know what this place used to do, but it's going to make for some fantastic backdrops for some photos. So we're gonna knock out hopefully a dozen or so photos. I may be able to pull out two or three bangers, but we're running late. We gotta get back to the main location for lunch and to swap bikes with other riders. So I'm putting this down so that we can knock out these photos. Okay, I am going to do my best to give you the rundown on these bikes. I am by no means a professional motorcycle reviewer, so I promise you I am going to miss telling you something that you want to hear or want to know. Please don't flame me for it. Look it up and figure it out and let me know what I missed, because I'm always willing to learn. So I'm here today for the launch of the Meteor 350 by Royal Enfield. Now, I have experience with Royal Enfield. I've owned a couple, I've ridden a bunch, and they're really good bikes. And over the years, they have become really great bikes. The amount of effort and engineering that they have put into bikes since the 2014 that I first had till now is night and day difference. And they truly are a great motorcycle now. Now, the 350, it's an all new engine, it's an all new frame, it's an all new everything. They were telling us even how they went down to designing and building the switches and indicators and everything like that. This engine is remarkable. I didn't have high hopes getting on a 350. I figured it was gonna be really buzzy because it's a single cylinder. This bike is so smooth, and it's peppy. It's not crazy powerful, but it'll do highways no problem at all. It's got low end grunt to really get it out of the hole and get you moving. It's got enough high end power that if you're at the top of a gear and you need to pass somebody, you still have some power at tap if you roll onto the throttle. The frame and the bike itself, the overall ergonomics and seating position, really low seat, really comfortable seat. It's not super wide, so a guy like me, who's 165 tall with really short legs, still really comfortable on the bike. It's got a kind of forward seating position for me. I kept forgetting where to put my feet because I've got rear sets on my Triumph, and these are out front. It also has a heel toe shifter, which I think is awesome. This thing, it is, I mean, rock your heel down, grab the next gear. I promise you I'm gonna get on my bike to go home, and I'm gonna go to rock the heel down, and I'm gonna miss a gear. All in all, I can't say enough about this bike. I am thoroughly impressed with it. If you're new to motorcycling or getting back into motorcycling, this is a great bike to consider. It's reasonably priced. I'll put the price down here. They told me, I don't want to misquote it, but new, it comes with a 3-year warranty and roadside assistance. I think this is the perfect bike for the city and for somebody who periodically wants to get out onto the highways and go and explore. The bike is so nimble. It turns on a dime. I can't say enough about it. I am so impressed with this bike. And I look forward to hopefully being able to ride it a little bit more often. And I think you could do some pretty cool custom stuff with it. But that's pretty much it for now. That's a wrap for the day. I've gotten all the photos that I needed to do. Everybody's out on a highway ride. I wanted to stay behind and do some filming and stuff. So I'm gonna cut it off here. I'm gonna get on the bike and get back to, I wish I could take the water taxi all the way back to Amsterdam. But no, I'm gonna jump back on the Triumph and I'm gonna head back to Amsterdam. Thanks for watching. If you like this stuff, consider subscribing. Hit that bell button. I'm told that it helps. And until the next time, safe riding.